another rule, and that is by adding ies. But here you have to remember one thing, that if a noun is ending in y, then you have to drop the y and add ies. Now look at the first word. The first singular word is city, and it is ending with y. So how you will change this into plural? You will drop the y and you will add ies, and the spelling of city will become cities, cities. Now look at the second word. The singular form is family. It is also ending with y. So how you will change this into plural? Yes, by dropping the y and adding ies. So the spelling will be families. Now see the third word. The third word is lady. This is a singular noun. You have to make it plural. So drop the y and instead of y add ies. So the spelling of ladies will be l-a-d-i-e-s. Now have a look at the last word. The last word is story. So the spelling is s-t-o-r-y. Now you have to make it plural. So you will drop the y and you will add i-e-s. So the spelling will be s-t-o-r-i-e-s. This is the plural form. So children, remember the rule that if a noun is ending in y, you have to drop the y and you have to add ies. Children, now have a look at the last rule of changing the noun from singular to plural. And that is that if a noun ends in f or fe, then you have to drop f or fe and you have to add ves. So children, have a look at the first word. The first word is thief. T-H-I-E-F, thief. And we have to make it plural. So we will drop the F and instead of F, we will add V-E-S. So the spelling will become T-H-I-E-V-E-S. Now have a look at the second word. The second word is knife. K-N-I-F-E, knife. And it is ending with F-E. So we have to drop F-E and instead of that we have to add V-E-S. So the plural form will become K-N-I-V-E-S. Now the third word, S-C-A-R-F, scarf. This is a singular noun. Make it plural and you will drop the F and you will write V-E-S instead of F. So the spelling will become S-C-A-R-V-E-S. And the last word, W-O-L-F, wolf. It is ending with F. So children, drop the F and write V-E-S. So the spelling will become W-O-L-V-E-S. Children, remember the rule. If the noun is ending with F or F-E, then drop the F or F-E and add V-E-S.
So children, you have learnt the rules of changing singular noun to plural noun. Now let's have a look at some irregular nouns where we do not follow the rules of adding ES, S, VES or IES. So here we change the vowel. So let's have a look. Here the vowel A is changed to vowel E. So the example is man, M-A-N, man. Now we will change it to men. Man is a singular noun, men is a plural noun. So the other example is woman and women. So here we have changed, the spelling is W-O-M-A-N. And here women's spelling is W-O-M-E-N. So did you notice that we changed the vowel to make it a plural noun? Yes, dear children. So here are some other examples where we will change double O to double E. Now foot, F-O-O-T, foot. F-E-E-T, feet. It is the plural of foot. Goose, geese. Tooth, teeth. Now, did you notice that we changed double O to double E to make the plural noun? Now, children, there are some words where we do not change the spelling. It remains the same, nor we add anything to it. For example, fish, the plural will be fish. Deer, the plural will be deer. Sheep, the plural will be sheep only. We will not add anything, nor we will change the vowel. And in some words, there is a complete change of the spelling. For example, mouse will turn to mice. Person, people. So the plural of person is people, which is totally changed. Now children, there are some words where we add en to make it plural. For example, child, we make it children. Ox, oxen. So happy learning!